Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you through this video lecture series on the subject heat and mass transfer. And this is lecture number 104 on the module conduction heat transfer. And in this lecture, we will discuss about the thermal contact resistance. And we recap from the previous lecture, we discussed the heat transfer in composite slab and we solved a few problems on the heat transfer in the composite slab. And here in this lecture, at the end of this lecture, learning outcome to the student will be able to explain what is thermal contact resistance, and the student will be able to solve problems with the thermal contact resistance. And we solved the problems and we discussed the theory on the composite slab. There are two layers of the slab. So this is layer 1 and this is layer 2. The arrangement of these two layers is called as composite slab. And you find many applications in mechanical engineering, particularly industrial heat transfer. In the case of a boiler wall, we have the steel pipeline or steel plate and then insulating material. And if you take a building, the cross section of the wall, you have the brick layer, plaster, I mean the mortar layer, plastering layer, everything. So we have two layer, always we find two material of different thermal conductivity are joined together, that is what called as composite layer. And in general assumption, we assume that there is no heat leakage in the joint between the two layers. But if you look at the joint between the two layers in a closer view, you find like this. So the layer 1 is of material 1, thermal conductivity K1, and layer 2 is some other material with thermal conductivity K2, and the heat transfer temperature profile, what we assume, there is no temperature drop. There is no temperature drop across the joint. But when you look at the joint closely, we may find voids. And these voids are due to the surface irregularity, surface roughness of the two surfaces. And when we join the surfaces together, so the surface irregularity or the roughness of the surface, it produces many voids on the vertical direction. And what is there inside the void? Inside the void, we have the surrounding fluid. Suppose the composite wall is exposed to the atmospheric air, the air will be there in the gap. The composite wall is exposed to some liquid, for example, water will be there inside the voids. So what is the effect of the fluid in the void? So the thermal conductivity of the fluid like air or water is very much lower than the thermal conductivity of the material. So this leads to temperature drop across the contact area. So that is what given here. So this is the T1 is the temperature in the end of this layer and T2 is the temperature here. There will be temperature drop due to the contact resistance. So this is very important when you design an industrial heat exchanging device or industrial heat transfer equipment. And how to minimize the void resistance due to the voids. So it is reducing the thermal contact resistance. There are different methods. Increasing the pressure of the fluid. So we have some fluid inside. We have to increase the pressure. Increasing the interface temperature or decreasing the surface roughness. So third option is very, very much possible. We can have highly polished surfaces. We can polish the surface before we join together. That is what the better method among the three alternatives. Now, what is the effect of thermal contact resistance in the heat transfer? We'll try to understand with the help of two problems. Example number 1, this is again from the Anna University question paper. A composite wall separates combustion gases at 2600 degrees Celsius from a liquid coolant at 100 degrees Celsius with the gas and the liquid inside. Gas and the liquid side convection coefficient 50 and 1000 watts per meter square Kelvin. The wall is composed of 10 mm thick layer of beryllium oxide of thermal conductivity 272 watts per meter Kelvin and 20 mm thickness of steel, stainless steel of thermal conductivity 14.9 watts per meter Kelvin on the liquid side. The contact resistance between the beryllium oxide and the steel is 0.05 meter square Kelvin by watts of the liquid side. What is the heat loss per unit surface area of the composite and calculate the interface temperatures. And this is what the arrangement. We have the gas on the left side. The first layer is of beryllium oxide and the second layer is of stainless steel. And here we have the liquid coolant and this is what contact resistance. And the L1 thickness is L1 equal to 0.01 meter of thermal conductivity 272 watts per meter Kelvin. L2 equal to 0.02 meter of thermal conductivity 14.9 watts per meter Kelvin. Gas temperature is 2600 degrees Celsius. Liquid temperature is 100 degrees Celsius. Gas side heat transfer coefficient is 50 watts per meter square Kelvin. Liquid side heat transfer coefficient is 1000 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the contact resistance is 0.05 meter square Kelvin by watts. So this is what the thermal circuit, corresponding thermal circuit for the arrangement. So resistance to the gas, first layer contact resistance, second layer stainless steel, and convection resistance due to the liquid. We calculate all the resistances. Ag equal to Rg equal to 1 by A into Hg, which is 1 by area equal to 1 meter square, 1 by 50 equal to 0.02. R1 equal to L1 by A into K1, which is 0.01 divided by 1 into 272 equal to 3.67 10 power minus 5. And R2 equal to L by A into K2, which is 0.02 divided by 1 into 14.9 equal to 0.00134. And RL equal to 1 by A into HL equal to 1 by 1000 equal to 0.001 degree Celsius per watts. And rate of heat transfer, Q equal to the extreme temperature Tg minus TL divided by Rg plus R1 plus Rc plus R2 plus RL. Here Rc is the contact resistance given in the problem. So substitute the numerical values. Q equal to 2600 minus 100 divided by 0.02 plus 3.67 10 power minus 5 plus 0.05 plus 0.00134 plus 0.001, which is 34,541.5 watts. So the rate of heat transfer equal to 34,541.5 watts. And the interface temperature, so Q equal to Tg minus T1 divided by the corresponding resistance Rg. So here T1 equal to Tg minus Q into Rg. So 2600 minus 34,541.5 into 0.02, which is 1909.17 degrees Celsius. And to calculate the temperature T2, so Q equal to T1 minus T2 divided by R1, where T2 equal to T1 minus Q into R1, which is 1909.17 minus 34,541.5 into 3.67 10 power minus 5, which is 1907.9. So 1907.9 degrees Celsius. And to calculate the T2 dash, temperature drop due to the contact resistance, Q equal to T2 minus T2 dash divided by R1 equal to R1, so which is from here T2 dash equal to T2 minus Q into RC, which is 180 degrees Celsius. So T2 dash equal to 180 degrees Celsius. Now look at the temperature drop due to the contact resistance. T2 equal to 1907.9 degrees Celsius, whereas T2 dash equal to 180.8 degrees Celsius. There is drastic temperature difference due to the contact resistance. And finally, T3 equal to Q equal to T3 minus TL divided by RL. So from here, we calculate T3 equal to 134.5 degrees Celsius. So we calculated the interface temperature and finally we consulted the answer for the problem. Rate of heat transfer equal to 34,541.5 degrees Celsius and the various temperatures T1 equal to 1909.17 degrees Celsius, T2 equal to 1907.9 degrees Celsius, T2 dash equal to 180.8 degrees Celsius and T3 equal to 134.5 degrees Celsius. And we take another example. Consider a plain composite wall that is composed of two material of thermal conductivity K equal to 0.1 watts per meter Kelvin and KB equal to 0.4 watts per meter Kelvin, or thickness LA equal to 10 millimeter, LB equal to 20 millimeter. Thermal contact conductance equal to 3.33 watts per meter square Kelvin. And material A adjoins a fluid at 200 degrees Celsius with a H value equal to 10 watts per meter square Kelvin. And material B adjoins a fluid at 40 degrees Celsius with a H value equal to 20 watts per meter square Kelvin. Calculate the rate of heat transfer and the interface temperatures. The height and width of the composite wall is 2 meter and 2.2 meter respectively. And this is the arrangement. So the fluid on left side at temperature 200 degrees Celsius, the heat transfer coefficient 10 watts per meter square Kelvin. And here on the right side, we have the fluid at 40 degrees Celsius with the heat transfer coefficient 20 watts per meter square Kelvin. And here we have the thermal contact conductance 3.33 watts per meter square Kelvin. And these are all the data given. Ka equal to 0.1 watts per meter Kelvin, Kb equal to 0.4 watts per meter Kelvin, La thickness of the slab A equal to 0.01 meter, and thickness of the slab B is 0.02 meter, and the area of the slab is area for the heat transfer equal to 2 into 2.2, which is 4.4 meter square. And this is what your thermal resistance circuit for the arrangement. And clearly read the problem, understand it, and try to represent the data in the form of a diagram, and as well as you write down the given data. So when you complete this information, that indicates that you very well understand the problem, and it is easy for you to solve the problem further. And the thermal contact resistance equal to 1 by thermal contact conductance. What is given here in the problem is thermal contact conductance. So we have to calculate thermal contact resistance. So which is HC equal to 1 by 3.33 equal to 0.3 meter square Kelvin by watts. The value of the thermal resistances, all the values we calculate RI equal to 1 by A into HA, which is 1 by 4.4 into 10 equal to 0.0227. And RA equal to LA by A into HA, which is 0.01 divided by 4.4 into 0.1 equal to 0.0227. And RC equal to 1 by A into HC divided by 1 by 4.4 into 0.3 equal to 0.757. RB equal to LB by A into KB, which is 0.02 divided by 4.4 into 0.04 equal to 0.114 degrees Celsius per Kelvin. And RO equal to 1 by A into HO, which is equal to 1 by 4.4 into 20, which is 0.0114 degrees Celsius. And the rate of heat transfer, we calculate Q equal to Ti minus To divided by all the resistances RI plus RA plus RC plus RB plus RO. So substituting all the resistances, 200 minus 40 divided by 0.0227 plus 0.0227 plus 0.757 plus 0.114 plus 0.0114. So all the values, so heat transfer Q equal to 119.7 watts. And calculate the interface temperature, Q equal to Ti minus T1 divided by Ri. So from here, T1 equal to Ti minus Q into Ri. Substitute the numerical values, T1 equal to 197.3 degree Celsius. And Q equal to T1 minus T2 divided by Ra. So T2 equal to T1 minus Q into Ra. Substitute the numerical values, T2 equal to 194.58 degree Celsius. And Q equal to T2 minus T2 dash divided by RC. So T2 dash equal to T2 minus Q into RC. Substitute the numerical values, T2 dash equal to 103.96 degree Celsius. And T3 equal to calculate T3, we take Q equal to T3 minus T1 divided by RO. So T3 equal to TL plus Q into RL, which is 41.36 degree Celsius. Now look at the value, T2 equal to 194.58 degree Celsius and T2 dash equal to 103.96 degree Celsius. You will find the difference. You will find the temperature drop across the contact resistance. And the answers for the problem, rate of heat transfer equal to 119.7 watts. Interface temperature T1 equal to 197.3 degree Celsius, T2 equal to 194.58 degree Celsius, T2 dash equal to 103.96 degree Celsius, and T3 equal to 41.36 degree Celsius. And these are all the reference books I used for preparation of the notes. and you can refer to it for further clarification. And you can reach to my book published by Anuradha Publication Chennai for further problem on the same topic. And if you have any doubt, you can write to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer to all your queries. Thank you very much for listening to the video lecture, and we'll meet again in the next lecture.